I just saw the enforcer try to stop this rider and he ran away.
Pinapat na bigan eh. Nasa gobyerno ka ba? Saan? Ay, bakit natatakbo? Pinapatigil ka na eh. Naka-uniforme din yun eh. Gusto mo bang hindi ka rin igaling pag naka-uniforme ka?
Bad luck for him. There's a lot of enforcers up ahead and he's been forced to stop. I saw it myself. The enforcer tried to stop him. He suddenly went around them and then tried to escape. The initial violation is passenger without a helmet. And actually, there's another rider here. You'll see the female on the back. Unfortunately, isn't wearing a helmet. And they just finished writing the ticket to this rider. You might think, what's the problem? He has shoes, pants, jacket, helmet. Problem is, the helmet was on his handlebar instead of his head. That's why he was issued a ticket for 1,500 pesos. Imagine that, you have a helmet, but it's just on your handlebar. I crossed the road because I saw the enforcers picking up this Jeep for illegal parking. You'll see it's right next to the big sign that says no parking. And I recognize this Jeep. This is the exact same one that was impounded a week ago because there was a young boy at the wheel of the jeepney, no driver's license. And you may remember there's no license plate on the back and they didn't write the license plate on the side of the Jeep either. I'm guessing that might be the proper driver over there, the one that came out in a bath towel. Obviously he's too late because they've already started pulling it onto the tow truck. Now the driver's complaining because a water pipe on the road got broken. The driver said it's his pipe and then he asked me to take a video of it. The thing is, why is your pipe on a public road where it could get busted? And that motorcycle was flagged down because the gentleman on the back wasn't wearing a helmet. I don't know why people want to take their chance. The roads are already quite dangerous. And then you don't wear a helmet, you're putting yourself at a bigger risk. They just flagged down this rider now because the woman on the back was not wearing a helmet. As soon as the enforcers tried to flag her down, she said, I have a helmet. She was holding it instead of wearing it. What a waste of 1,500. Aside from being a waste of money on the ticket, it's dangerous not to wear a helmet. And I believe this street was actually subject of a complaint. I think that's how they ended up here in the first place. And if you're wondering, yes, there are signs that say no parking both sides. It's been quite a while, no driver's come out for this one yet, so I guess we'll see the tow truck any moment. I'll have to check my previous footage to know if this was also towed away last time. I can't recall, to be honest. And just behind that little silver one, they're about to pull this onto the tow truck. They just flagged down a member of the Janato gang. Said he's wearing slippers because he's just going nearby, but near or far, the same rules apply. And realistically, the enforcer has no way of knowing how far you're going. It's easy to say you're going nearby, no matter what. And the team just flagged down this motorcycle now. Unfortunately, the passenger on the back wasn't wearing a helmet. This street has a one-side parking ordinance on the left, but no parking allowed on the right. That's why they're now issuing tickets to motorcycles and cars parked here. This is an alternative route for the Sona, the upcoming Sona. That's why it's being cleared. This is often the reality of one-side parking ordinances. Instead of fixing the problem, they just legalized it on one side. And people still park on the other side anyway. Instead of adjusting the property to accommodate the car, they just took over the sidewalk. Although right next to those parked cars, you'll see they turned it into an eatery. My goodness. They've been waiting for someone to come out and give a license and move this car and motorcycle. So far, nobody. So I think they're going to be towed away. Although my suspicion is once they see the tow truck, that's the time they're going to show their license. And there you go. That was the solution. Tell them that the vehicle is going to be towed. Suddenly she came back with a driver's license. And someone also handed over a license for this car and he's taking the cover off. I don't know if he's really the driver or... As long as he can show a license and then move the vehicle, that's what matters. And if you're wondering about signages, yes, there's very large signs along here. Mummy has a helmet, daddy has a helmet. For the child, completely unprotected on the motorcycle. So excess passenger, plus slippers, plus no helmet, if all violations are added to the ticket. Potentially even the Children's Safety on Motorcycle Act. And of course, they have to find alternative transport. They can't still ride the bike. Right now, they're writing out a ticket to this pickup truck parked on the sidewalk. That might be the driver that just lifted the shutter. Yep, he's getting in the vehicle now. So as long as he shows his license, he can drive away with just a ticket instead of being towed. And it's not just cars that are being ticketed, even the motorcycles on the sidewalk. That's why they paint the sidewalk like that on the corner, to remind you not to park there. But a lot of drivers just park wherever. And there you go, the towing crew is hooking up to it now. I did see one of the vendors shouting at a house, I guess to try and wake up the driver. But it looks like they've already connected the bar, so even if he comes out. There's another one being towed away over here, same thing, parked on the corner. I suspect that might be the same one that was towed away before, where the guy argued it's not a corner, despite being a corner, so he's gonna be unhappy if that's him again.